Good morning, students. I am Mr. Evan Solisa. This morning, we are going to be discussing biology, and our topic is the nervous system. Now, what are our specific objectives? At the end of this lesson, I should be able to define nervous system, define nerves, list the parts of the nervous system, explain the parts of the nervous system, explain the structures of the central nervous system, explain the functions of the central nervous system. All right, let's get into the lecture properly. What is nervous system? Nervous system is a complex network of nerves and cells that transmit signals or messages to and from the body. What do we mean by that? Take for instance, you are watching a television and your younger sibling came behind you from the back and pierced you with a pin. Immediately, what happens? You get what? You are like, shocked. What's that? Now, that signal that was sent to your body, or that message that was sent to your body, is as the result or is through the help of the nervous system. Okay? It's through the help of the nervous system. So what are we saying? Nervous system is a complex network. Is that tunnel of nerves and cells in the body, is the combination of nerves and cells in the body that transmits signals or messages to the body and from the body. Okay? Now, what are nerves? Nerves are whitish fibers or bundle of fibers in the body that transmit impulse of sensation to the brain. I gave an example with the pin. I said you are watching a television and your younger sibling pierced you with a pin unknowing to you. Now, that impulse that was transmitted, that impulse that was conveyed into your body, okay, is as a result of the nerves in your body. The nerves is that the nerves are those fibers that sense that sensation into your body. Okay, so nerves are whitish fibers or bundle of fibers in the body that aid in the transmitting or conveying, okay, of impulse or sensation to the brain. Or take for instance, you have your little sister in the house and you on the candle at home, and your baby sister of 9 months, she's still crawling, and as she keeps crawling, she gets to where the candle is, and viewing the candle, she just fixes her hands on the candle. Now, when she puts her hand on the fire, immediately she pulls it out. Now, what gave that sensation is the nerves. The nerves in our body immediately transmitted the sensation to our brain, and immediately you just see her pull off her hands from the fire. So we're talking about the nervous system as a complex network of nerves and cells that transmits, that carries message to the body or from the body. Okay? And we are saying that nerves, from the word nervous system, we have the word nerves. It's also a white, it's also whitish fibers or bundle of fibers in the body that transmit impulse of sensation. This is what aids in the sensation that gets you aware that this has just occurred, and immediately you just get yourself, and it sends message to the brain or to the body. What does that is what the nerves. I believe that you are following. Okay, now we have parts of the nervous system. We have parts of the nervous system, and we're going to be looking at two for this for the course of this study. We are going to be looking at the central nervous system, which is called the CNS, central nervous system, as the word implies, central. Okay, when we talk about something that is central, it means that we have other parts, okay, coordinated to it. All right, when we say something is central, it means that it is responsible for other parts around it. Are you following me? So we also have the peripheral nervous CNS, which the peripheral nervous system, which is called the RNS. Okay, let's look at it. Let's start with the central nervous system. The central nervous system, this is made up of basically the brain and the spinal cord. Okay, this is made up of basically the brain and the spinal cord. All right, so what are we trying to say? What we are saying in essence is that the central nervous system comprises of the brain and the spinal cord. And in the course of this service, in the course of this lecture rather, we are going to make sure that we look at the brain and the spinal cord. Okay, the peripheral nervous system, this is made up of nerves that branch off from the spinal cord and extends to all parts of the body. Now remember, we said that the central nervous system is basically made up of just the brain and the spinal cord. So there is no other part of the body that is linked to this. Okay, but that of the peripheral nervous system, it is linked off from the spinal cord and extends now to all other parts of the body. And extends to what? All other parts of the body. That is why under the peripheral nervous system, we are going to be looking at things like somatic nervous system. And when we get to that place, we are going to get the clarity properly. All right? Now, you can see this tree. You can see this branch. It's going to help you in remembering the types of nervous system. For instance, maybe if you are asked in an examination or a test, give the types of the nervous system and the sub branches. I think with the aid of this diagram, you should be able to give the answer to the question. Okay, you can see from here the nervous system. Then we have two branches. We now have the central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system. And under the central nervous system, we have the brain and the spinal cord. And under the peripheral nervous system, we have the somatic and the autonomic. All right. Now, let's look at the brain. The brain. Remember, we said that the central nervous system basically consists of the brain and the spinal cord. So let's look at the brain. The brain is one of the largest and most complex organs in the human body. We say the brain is one of the largest and most complex organs in the human body. That is, we are saying that out of all the organs found in the human body, the brain is one of the largest and the most complex. Why? Because almost all the parts of the body are glued and coordinate and conjoined to what? To the brain. Okay? So the brain masterminds almost every activity of the body. That is why even the eyes, every part of the body is what? Is connected to the brain. That's why we say the brain is the most complex. So it is active every twofold. You see, that's why when your brain goes damaged, automatically you are almost gone. Because the brain is what coordinates almost every activity of the body. Okay, fine. The brain is one of the largest and most complex organs in the human body. It is located in the head and protected with a skull. Of course, you know where your brain is located. Your brain is located where? In the head. And what? Protected with what? A skull. Now, it is made up of more than 100 billion of nerves. Don't forget what we talked about nerves. Okay? Don't forget what we talked about nerves. We define nerves in the course of the start of this lecture. Okay? Now, we say that it is made up of more than 100 billion of nerves that communicates in trillions of connections called synapses. So if you are asked in an exam hall or in a test, what are synapses? What can you say? These are what? These are connections of what? Of nerves that communicate or are linked what together. We say that the brain is made up of 100 billions of nerves that communicate in trillions of connections called synapses. So in the reverse, I can ask you in an exam, define synapses, and you will tell me that these are connections of nerves that communicate together. Okay, it's as simple as that. All right, let's move on. The brain is made up of many specialized areas that works together. Don't forget, from the start, we have established that the brain is the most complex organ of the body. So why is it the most complex? One of the reasons is because it is made up of specialized areas that works together. The brain receives information through our five senses. The brain does what? Receives information through our five senses. Now, take for instance, when you pick up, let me say, a sour food. Maybe you've kept a food for some period of time, and it has gone sour. Okay, after 2 days or thereabout, and it begins to sting. It begins to smell. Now, when you get to the kitchen where the food is, you can see it. You can see the food. Now, you saw the food through what sense? Through the eye. Is that right? Through the eye. And it has sent a signal to the brain through our nerves. Are we together? Now, you can smell the food through what? The nose. Is that right? You can pick up the food with the plate, with your hands. Now, you can also go forward to test the food with your tongue. And even while you are trying to test if the food is really sour, you can hear your mom scream at you. Say, Kai, don't eat that food. You heard your mom scream with your ears. So you can see that virtually almost all the senses The five sense organs are being what? In action. Are we together? Almost the five sense organs are what? Are in action. And if you don't want to hear when your mom is calling you, she can easily beat you. And with your skin, you can feel the what? That pain through the beat. So what are we trying to say? The brain receives information through our five sense organs, through our five senses, often many at one time. So at the same time, all this is occurring. You are smelling the food, you are touching the plate, you can even taste at the same minute. You are hearing your mom calling you, say, leave that plate. If you don't want to leave the plate, she beats you and you feel it. Now, you know, once you are beaten, the skin helps you in feeling. Of course, the skin is a sense organ that helps you what? To feel. The skin helps you in feeling the pain. And it has sent a signal to the brain at the same time through the what? Through the nerves. Don't forget, we established that the nerves is that part of this nervous system that does what? That aids in sensation. Okay? That aids what? In what? In sensation. Are we together? All right. Now, functions of the brain. The brain aids in attention and concentration. You know, when you see a madman on the road, you see he's perplexed, he's perturbed, he's just moving randomly. He's not organized. He's not concentrated. You can call him, he will not hear you. His attention is not there. Why? Because he has issues with the brain. So when your brain is faulted, you lack attention and you lack concentration. So in the reverse of it, when your brain is functional, you have the attention and concentration. Like as I'm talking to you now, you are attentive and you are concentrating to this lecture. Why? Because you have a functional brain. So the brain aids in attention and what? Concentration. It also helps in organization, self-organization. All right? Somebody that does not have a functional brain is not organized. I gave an instance with a what? With a madman. He's not organized. He's roaming around. He's going up and down. He can't sit one place. Okay? Brain also helps in self-monitoring. You can monitor yourself. You can put yourself in check. Okay? You can put yourself in what? In check. You know that you are supposed to wake up by 5:30 in the morning. You are supposed to take your shower by 6 o'clock. You are supposed to eat your breakfast by 7 o'clock. You are supposed to go to the market by 9 o'clock. Now, it is your brain that helps you in what? In that checkmating. You are supposed to go to the church by 5 p.m. You are supposed to take your siesta by 2 o'clock and all of that. So when you have your plans for the day, your brain helps you in doing what? In achieving that plan by checkmating yourself, by monitoring yourself. Even when you have when you take your siesta, you know you are supposed to wake up by 3-4 o'clock. It's your brain that helps you to do that. And immediately you put your alarm, you set your alarm by 2 o'clock or 3 p.m. Once your alarm rings, the nerve, it sends a message to the brain. Okay, don't forget, the nerves is the watchword. The nerves sends the message to the brain. Say, come on, pick up, stand up. It's time for the lecture. It's time for church, and so on and so forth. So that's why we say the brain helps in self-monitoring. I've talked about organization. Now, it helps also in awareness. Awareness is synonymous to self-monitoring. It makes you to be aware of your environment. Now, what do we mean by that? Take for instance, you are in a gathering, you are somewhere gathering somewhere, and you hear the siren of the policemen. Wow, 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 wow. Immediately, the nerves have sent the message and signal to your brain. You say, come on, there's danger, there's danger. Get lost, run away. Now, it's the brain that helps you to be checkmated, to be aware of what? Of your environment. You can imagine a man that is paralyzed in his brain or has a shock. Shock is the default of the brain. Or a madman that does not even know, that does not have the awareness of his environment. Even when they are coming to arrest him, he cannot know because the brain is defaulted. Are we together? So the brain also helps what? In inhibition of behavior. What do we mean inhibition of behavior? When we talk about inhibition, it means if, take for instance, maybe someone that is temperamental, you are always angry, or you are addicted to a particular behavior. If you tell yourself, oh, God help me, I want to stop smoking, I want to stop drinking, I want to stop one activity or the other, it's the brain that helps you to do that. To do what? To reduce what? That behavior inhibits it. Through what? Through the brain. Okay, let's push forward. All right, the spinal cord. The spinal cord is a long, thin, tubular structure made of nervous tissues, which extends from the medulla oblongata in the brain stem to the lumbar region of the vertebral column. It encloses the central canal of the spinal cord, which contains the cerebrospinal fluid. What are we saying? We are just giving the structure of the spinal cord. And we are saying that the spinal cord is a long, thin, tubular structure made of nervous tissues. So for the fact that it is made of nervous tissues is complex, because don't forget we discussed nervous tissues as being complex, made of nervous tissues which extends from the medulla oblongata in the brain stem to the lumbar region of the vertebral column. All right, what are the functions of the spinal cord? Now, the spinal cord, don't forget the spinal cord is also a sub under the central nervous system. Are we together? So, we are looking at the central nervous system for today. In our next lecture, we'll be looking at the peripheral nervous system, where we are going to talk about the somatic and the autonomic. So the function of the spinal cord relays message from the brain to different parts of the body. The spinal cord relays message, it converses, it carries message, it transmits message from the brain to the different parts of the body. Remember, I gave you an example with your little one touching the candlelight. I also gave an example of you watching television, and all of a sudden from the back, your younger one pierced you with a needle. And that message, suddenly you get that impulse, that signal from the brain to the different parts of your body is being carried through the spinal cord. Now, it passes message from the sensory receptors to the brain. Remember, we said it takes message first from the brain to different parts of the body, but now it's taking message from the receptor, from the sensory receptor. Now, if I pierce your body, or I pinch your lips or your hand, look at what I'm doing. I pinch you. If you pinch yourself, okay, let's experiment it. Pinch yourself now. As you pinch yourself, now the nerves converts that, the nerves takes the message, pam, to your brain. Already your brain has received the message that there has been a pain from your skin. Alright? So the spinal cord passes message from the sensory receptor. Is right now your skin is that sensory receptor, is the one that received the pain, and it has taken the message to the brain. Now it coordinates reflexes that are managed by the what? By the spinal cord alone. Reflex, impulse. You didn't expect that somebody is going to pierce you from the back. So immediately that reflex, that sudden reflex and impulse, okay, the spinal cord is responsible to manage it. It coordinates reflexes that are managed by the spinal cord alone. Okay, we are going to stop here for today. We looked at the nervous system, we looked at the nerves, we talk about nervous system as a complex organs and so on, complex structure and so on. We also looked at the nerve, okay, and we looked at the parts of the nervous system, and we talked about the central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system, and we tried to break the central nervous system. We say that it consists of the brain and the spinal cord only. So we now talked about the brain, and we also talked about the spinal cord. In our next lecture, we are going to be talking about the peripheral nervous what? System. Okay? Stay safe.